Oh, good morning. Lynn Voigt from Wisconsin Garden. I've been thinking and wondering what I could eat, what I could make during the winter that's really, really healthy for you. And you all know sprouts are good for you. Some of us like them. Some of us are, I don't know. And sometimes there's scares in the store that they have E. coli in them or, you know, they're not good. So if you did them at home, you wouldn't have that worry. So Rick and I went to the store and happened to see a sprout growing kit. So we got one. And I planted them a little over a week ago. And we've used 3/4 of them. There's another stack that goes on here. We already ate those. These are broccoli seeds. You just eat them. You can taste how healthy they are for you. You put them on your sandwich. You put them in a salad. They're so easy to grow and they're so fun. Kids would love it. All you do is you sprinkle your seeds in, put some water. I'll show you later how to do it. I'm going to have a few more. Whoa, too many. It's going to be on my sandwich for lunch. Get back in there. Put your little heads back in there. I'll give you some more water. And today I am setting up my sprout machine. I use my sprouter. Sprouts are really good for you. They are what happens when you plant a seed and it first pops open and then gets its first little green leaves. Those are so good for you that when we saw this little sprouting kit at the Home Depot, we thought, well, let's try it. They're great on salads and in sandwiches. This is what you get. It's a little kit. It has 4 pieces to it. These are the sprouting trays. And it comes with 3 different kinds of sprouts. It's got the broccoli, the mung beans, and the zesty mix, which is radishes and broccoli and some kind of a lettuce, an endive that's a little bit spicy, and it really is spicy. It's so easy. All you do is decide which sprouts you want to sprout. You open up the little envelope. You sprinkle them into the first tray. Just about that much. You don't need a whole lot. One jumped over here. And then I think those were the broccoli ones. And then the other one I want to do is the zesty one. It takes about 2 to 7 days for these to sprout to the point where they're big enough to eat. Then you rinse them off with regular old water. Still in there, kind of jiggle them. Set them on top of the drainage tray. Rinse these off. Some are little and they fall through, but oh well. Set that on top of that one. Then you set the cover on, and then twice a day you take it over to your sink, and this time I'm going to use filtered water, and you dump in a little bit of water. It doesn't have to be a lot. It trickles on through, catches in this bottom drain one. So once it's pretty much done, then you just empty this bottom one. I do it when I get up in the morning, and when I'm making dinner at night. Then, about a week later, this will all be green. You'll see them. They'll start sprouting. They get bigger. It's very exciting. The kids would love this. And you'll have seeds that you, or sprouts then, that you can use. And you can pull them out. If there's too many for you to use right away, put them in a plastic bag. I would put the paper toweling, make an envelope and put paper toweling in there just to keep them moist. Put them in a plastic bag, put them in the refrigerator, and then throw them on everything. And that way you could start a new batch and still have some left. So
you said you do what every morning, every day?
Every day you have to bring them to the sink or get a little pitcher. You dump the water in the top, it settles on down through, empty out this drainage.
So you just let it trickle through?
Right, and it doesn't take long. And that's it. You just do that twice a day. And that way, you know, it gives it enough water. You'll see that there's still some water in there. It's moist. Now, the only problem we found was once these seeds are gone, they did not give any indication of where you could get more. So I did have to go to the burpee.com website, and I did order some more seeds from them. I'm guessing you could use like radish seeds or broccoli seeds that you might buy at the store, but you have to be sure they haven't been treated. These say right on them, sprouting seeds. So you may want to experiment or do some research, but it's fun. Bye for now. Grow, little sprouts. I'm all out. Hurry.
You have a special place, by the way, where you have to keep them?
No, you don't. I usually set mine off to the side. I don't put it directly in the window. It's just on the counter, and you'll notice that they'll start growing toward the light, so then I just turn them. So I just set them over here. That's it. Thanks for watching our latest video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give us a thumbs up. Now, I have arranged for you a special treat. My husband Richard and I would like you to receive a free piece of artwork. Now, all you need to do is go to revoart.com, which is my husband's art website. You will find over 3,000 beautiful images there that he has created. And you may have one free. Choose wisely. You only get one. And it's only for your personal use. So go to revoart.com, pick out the title that you would like, and put it in an email to me, Lynn, at WisconsinGarden.net. Be sure you put the title and you put the DPC number that's next to the title with it, so we know exactly what you want. And keep an eye on your inbox because you will receive your special gift. Thanks again for watching. Bye-bye.